गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू, आई होप यू कैन हियर मी। हेमा, इज माय वॉइस ऑडिबल?
यस मैम, यस मैम।
सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे द पेल्विक वेसल्स एंड नर्व्स। टुमारो आई विल बी टेकिंग द जॉइंट्स एंड रेडियोग्राफी। सो विद दैट, like your abdomen is entirely finished, you also cross check if any topic is not done, you just write it to me on WhatsApp so that I can cover. As per my knowledge, everything is done. We are going according to the topics which are given in the textbook chapter wise, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so now let us see what are the pelvic vessels and nerves. So we will see the origin, termination, cores and branches of internal iliac artery. Okay, discuss the origin, site, relations, branches and also their final distribution of sacral plexus, because we have seen these only, no, when we were doing the supply of the pelvic visceral organs. Okay, so we will elaborate now. Then we will see the anatomy of autonomic supply of the pelvic organs. So we will try to highlight on these topics today. Okay, internal iliac artery, little bit of sacral plexus and autonomic supply of pelvic organs. Now, how is the internal iliac artery formed? Like from the abdominal aorta, we have right common iliac and left common iliac, isn't it? Each common iliac will be further dividing in front of the sacroiliac joint into external iliac artery and internal iliac artery. What is the continuation of external iliac artery? See, this is the inguinal ligament, right? Anterior superior iliac.
Femoral.
Very good. It continues as femoral artery.
And continues as pudendal.
Which one?
Femoral. Internal. No.
External
internal iliac, branch.
Internal branch. External iliac artery continues as femoral artery, beta. Okay, so common iliac artery is now dividing into two, external and internal. So internal iliac artery is passing down into the pelvic cavity. Do you remember this line? I told you iliopubic eminence, isn't it?
Yeah.
When we were doing the pelvic inlet, pelvic brim, is it not the part of pelvic brim? Yeah. You should understand everything in order to understand the course. Every word is precious here, so that you understand.
Yes, the section again, ma'am.
Kya beta?
Sagittal section again.
Can you please repeat beta?
Sagittal section again.
Ha, sagittal section hi hai beta. 100% this is sagittal section. Okay, your favorite. What is the name of this muscle?
Levator ani, ma'am.
Levator ani. What is this?
Obturator internus.
Excellent, very good. What is the one which is behind?
Piriformis.
Excellent. If you understand these, relations become very easy. Okay. Do you remember we have sacral foramina through which?
Yes.
This is ventral rami.
Sacral nerves.
Excellent, beta. S1, S2, S3, S4, isn't it? All sacral nerves are joining to form which nerve, beta? What is the name of this nerve?
Sciatic nerve.
Sciatic. Sciatic. Very good. Very good. Okay. So apart from this, you are finding higher up the other nerves like iliolumbar, like genitofemoral.
Can you repeat this point, ma'am? I lost connection. Just once.
See, this is the sacral foramina. From the sacral foramina, you are finding S1, S2, S3, S4 nerves. Okay? These are the ventral rami, because this is towards pelvic aspect, ventral aspect. So the ventral rami are all joining to form sciatic nerve. That means, what is the name of this foramen?
Greater sciatic notch.
Very good. Greater sciatic notch. Okay? So the internal iliac artery is this. It is passing downwards into the pelvis. At the upper margin of the greater sciatic notch, it is dividing into two divisions. Okay, you can see this is one and this is one. The one which moves anteriorly, it is cut. We will see in next picture. Mm-hmm. It is dividing into anterior and posterior divisions. Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is our abdominal aorta. Okay. So abdominal aorta is, you know, this is right common iliac, left common iliac, external iliac. Imad, you can see external iliac is continuing as you said, femoral. Okay. Mm-hmm. And this is internal iliac, which is entering into the pelvic cavity. This is our pelvic brim. It's going deeper inside. Okay. Now, so how many divisions it is dividing into?
Mm-hmm.
Anterior and posterior divisions, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I'm talking about internal iliac artery. Internal iliac artery is subdividing into how many subdivisions? Anterior and posterior.
Okay.
I'll show you the diagram again so that it goes into your memory. This is internal iliac and this is the anterior division, which is cut. Course is not shown here. This is posterior division. You can see it is going behind buttock side. Piche ekdam. Sacrum ke piche chale jari. Hena? Okay. So see, the posterior division is supplying the posterior abdominal wall, posterior pelvic wall and gluteal region. Okay. This is the posterior division. Anterior division, it comes anteriorly. It supplies all pelvic visceral organs. What are the pelvic visceral organs we have? Anterior to posterior. What are the pelvic?
Urinary bladder.
Yeah.
Uterus and rectum.
Huh. In case of females, urinary bladder, uterus and rectum. Whereas in case of males,
urinary bladder and rectum.
Huh. So obviously, the anterior division will come and supply all the pelvic visceral organs. Posterior one went behind. Okay. Anterior one will come and supply all the pelvic visceral organs. So what are those? It is pelvic viscera except ovary. Which artery is supplying the ovary?
Testicular artery.
No, gonadal artery. Gonadal.
Sorry. Gonadal artery.
Ovarian. Okay. Same. Gonadal artery in case of females, you call it as ovarian artery. In case of males, it is called as testicular.
Sorry. Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah. Okay. Pelvic viscera, perineum. It also, few branches go to gluteal region and branches also go to the adductor region of the thigh. Anybody remembers what are the muscles of adductor compartment of the thigh? As a review.
Adductor longus.
Very good.
Magnus.
Brevis, magnus. Brevis. One more is there. Two more are there, in fact. Who will tell? Pectineus and gracilis. No?
Okay.
So anterior division. This you just ignore the last point. Okay, now let us expand the branches of the internal iliac artery. So what are these anterior division arteries? So first you have umbilical artery. Okay, this is umbilical artery is seen during the fetal circulation. Okay, so it gives the superior vesical artery. Vesical means what? It supplies what?
Bladder.
Urinary bladder. Okay, so the distal fibrous part of this umbilical artery will become medial umbilical ligament. I told you three folds. Do you remember? Median umbilical ligament, medial umbilical ligament, lateral umbilical ligament. Median umbilical ligament, I told you, it's an embryonic remnant of urachus.
Urachus.
Ask me, what is urachus? I told you, I will discuss in embryology. Okay, median umbilical ligament is the remnant of umbilical artery. Umbilical artery will be seen in umbilical cord during fetal circulation. In adult, after birth, you will not see median umbilical artery. Instead, it will form a remnant. Okay, what is the name of that remnant? Median umbilical ligament. Okay. Anterior division, what is the next artery we have? Obturator artery. Okay, so obturator artery is supplying pelvic muscles, as you know very well, the levator ani, piriformis, obturator internus, all those muscles. Okay, so it is also supplying the muscles of medial compartment of thigh. Just now we have discussed the names, adductor longus, brevis, magnus, pectineus and gracilis. Not only that, obturator artery gives nutrient artery which goes and supplies the hip bone. Okay, then. So we also find inferior vesical artery. Vesicle means what?
Urinary bladder.
It is supplying the inferior aspect of urinary bladder. Not only that, in case of males, inferior vesical artery also supplies prostate glands and seminal vesicles, and it gives one branch which goes and supplies the vas deferens. What is the length of vas deferens, Abhinav? Centimeters, isn't it? What are the other structures measuring 45 centimeters in our body, Imad?
Thoracic ductulator.
Spinal cord.
Yeah, beta. Thoracic ductens.
Ma'am, a doubt, ma'am. Always I had this doubt. Like three structures you told, one length, no, ma'am. Like thoracic ductulator and one more thing. What is that?
This is beta. Vas deferens.
Acha, okay.
Vas deferens. Vas deferens. Okay. Remember now. Thoracic duct, vas deferens, and spinal cord. Okay?
Okay.
So these are the branches which are coming from anterior division. Okay? Now, continuing, we also have middle rectal artery. Okay? Middle rectal artery, obviously, as the name suggests, it is supplying the inferior part of the rectum. Not only that, it is also supplying seminal vesicles, prostate gland in males, and vagina in females. Okay? Now, internal pudendal artery. Imad, you were a little confused, no? If it was coming from external iliac. No, it is not a branch of external iliac. It's a branch of internal iliac anterior division. Okay? So, internal pudendal artery leaves the pelvis through greater sciatic foramen. We have seen pudendal canal or Alcock's canal. Do you remember? In which topic we have come across pudendal canal?
Ischiorectal fossa,
van structures, ischiorectal fossa. There you have pudendal artery, pudendal vein, and pudendal nerve, isn't it? So that means that force is going back now. So it lifts the pelvis through greater sciatic foramen, enters the perineum by passing through lesser sciatic foramen. That means it is taking a bend from greater sciatic to the lesser sciatic. It is entering the pudendal canal with the pudendal nerve. It supplies anal canal musculature. Anybody can repeat? What is the anal canal musculature which I told you yesterday? External anal sphincter is there. Internal anal sphincter is there.
External.
External three parts. Subcutaneous, superficial, and deep. This is voluntary. Internal is involuntary. Internal is the continuation of circular muscle. Okay. I'm only questioning. I'm only answering. Okay, fine. What to do? You should write part completion test. I will see. Okay. Supplies the anal canal musculature, skin, and muscles of perineum. Okay. This internal pudendal artery. So the other branches we have are inferior gluteal artery. Always try, if you don't remember anything, if you just remember the name also, you can write. Okay. Basically, it supplies the gluteal region. Nearby, it is also supplying pelvic diaphragm, piriformis muscle. Okay. This is QF, I don't remember, but long back I have prepared. Upper hamstrings, quadratus femoris, better. Quadratus femoris, yeah. What is, where do you find quadratus femoris? What are hamstrings?
Thigh region. Thigh, muscles of thigh.
Can you name hamstrings?
Gluteus maximus.
Hamstrings are posterior compartment muscles of the thigh. No, but semitendinosus. Adductor magnus is there. Adductor magnus is there. Semimembranosus, semitendinosus, biceps.
Semitendinosus.
Biceps femoris. Biceps femoris. And the hamstring part of the adductor magnus, because adductor magnus is found in the medial compartment also. Okay, so gluteus maximus and sciatic nerve. All these structures are supplied by inferior gluteal artery. Okay, uterine artery. It is seen only in case of females. It crosses the ureter. I told you we should be very careful not to get confused the uterine artery with the ureter, no? So it ascends in the layers of broad ligament of uterus. It ends by anastomosing with the ovarian artery. That means it is supplying the ovaries. It also supplies the uterus. Okay. Then vaginal artery, it is again seen only in case of females. Okay. So it is basically one vaginal branch, and also we have inferior vesical branch supplying the urinary bladder. Okay. So all these are the anterior division branches. So how many we have studied anterior division? Umbilical, obturator, inferior vesicle, middle rectal, internal pudendal, inferior gluteal, uterine artery, vaginal artery. Okay. So that these, now you can see, in fact, now posterior division is cut. Now we are able to see all anterior divisions. Okay. So what are the various umbilical artery we are able to see? I told you it is just remaining like a remnant. What is that remnant? Medial umbilical ligament. So the other branches like superior vesical artery, you can see inferior vesical artery, we can see. Okay. So middle rectal artery, inferior gluteal artery, internal pudendal artery. All anterior branches are shown here. So as to avoid confusion. So if posterior, posterior goes behind, right? Okay. So these are the branches from anterior aspect. So visceral, this I already told you, vaginal artery and uterine artery are the special arteries which are arising from the anterior subdivision. Okay, so that is ovarian artery, we know it is arising directly from abdominal aorta. Okay, these are the special branches which we see only in females from the anterior division of internal iliac artery. Now, coming to the posterior division of internal iliac artery. So, what are the various posterior branches we have? So, iliolumbar artery, these are all behind. Supplies psoas major, quadratus lumborum, iliacus and cauda equina. What is cauda equina?
Spinal cord, tail fibers.
Spinal cord nerves.
Okay. The bunch of nerves which are seen at conus medullaris. Okay.
Medullaris.
Okay. So we also have lateral sacral artery supplying piriformis. Erector spinae, where did we see? The long muscle which is extending throughout the back. Deeper
supporting
compartment. With the thoracolumbar fascia, I told you it is enclosing. Between the middle and posterior layer, we have erector spinae. Skin over the erector spinae and also structures in sacral canal. Okay, they are all supplied by lateral sacral artery. Okay, then superior gluteal artery supplies everywhere you are getting this, because this muscle is behind, no? Piriformis, gluteus maximus, medius and minimus, and tensor fascia lata. Tensor fascia lata also is one of the muscle of gluteal region. Okay, so these are the posterior branches. Okay, so you are finding iliolumbar artery, lateral sacral, superior gluteal. So that is all. Okay, beta. So in case if suddenly internal iliac artery is asked, I hope you got an idea now. So you should talk about where is it dividing? At the sacroiliac joint, isn't it? So you should talk about the anterior division, its branches, posterior division, its branches. Okay. Now correspondingly, you will have the veins also, no? So you will have the corresponding veins, so internal iliac veins with and their tributaries. So superior rectal vein, median sacral vein, gonadal vein, all these veins, where are they draining into? Internal iliac vein will drain into common iliac vein. Common iliac vein will drain into inferior vena cava. Okay. I talked something like internal vertebral venous plexus when we were talking about prostate. So this is the venous plexus which has communication with the dural venous sinuses. No, if there is any cancer in the prostate, through these veins the cancer may spread to the brain also. Okay, what is this? Superior rectal vein, middle rectal and inferior rectal veins. These are, superior rectal vein is the tributary of portal vein, middle and inferior rectal veins are the tributaries of the internal iliac vein, which further drains into common iliac, no? So this is portocaval anastomosis, no? So what is the difference between external piles and internal piles? Yesterday only I told you.
External,
painful, painless.
Okay, painful, painless. Which is painful, which is painless?
External, painful.
External is painful.
Why external is painful?
Sympathetic supply.
Are external.
Somatic.
Outside. Somatic. Isn't it? Okay. So now, so we will see the nerve supply. Now, just now you were telling me S1, S2, S3, S4, they are all joining, no? To form this sacrum nerve.
Okay.
So nerve supply of pelvis is basically coming from pelvic splanchnic nerves. Okay. So pelvic splanchnic nerves are basically coming from S2, S3 and S4. Okay. Here. So they are all preganglionic parasympathetic nerves to pelvic viscera and the derivatives of hindgut. What are the derivatives of hindgut?
Transverse colon and descending colon.
Left 1/3 of the transverse colon, then descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum. Anal canal has dual origin, isn't it?
Yes,
yesterday I told you.
Yes.
Endodermal origin and ectodermal origin.
Ectodermal origin.
That's why external points, internal points. Okay. Pelvic splanchnic nerves S2, S3 and S4. These are preganglionic parasympathetic nerves. Okay. Of pelvic viscera. That means they go and supply the pelvic viscera and also the derivatives of hindgut. So somatic is the one which is going to the surface of the body through sacral plexus. So somatic parts, they are derived from the L4, L5. You call it as lumbosacral trunk because they go and join with S1, S2, S3 and most of the S4 also. Okay. So this like L4, L5, S1, S2, S3, all these together, sometimes S4 also will join to form which plexus? Sacral plexus. Okay. So this is somatic means what? It is supplying muscles, bones, skin, and it is carrying the information to the brain, outside structures. Okay, that is somatic. Okay, visceral means what? It is supplying internal organs like urinary bladder, uterus, and rectum, anal canal. So those are pelvic splanchnic. Splanchnic means visceral nerves. So what is the root value of visceral nerves? S2, S3, S4. Okay, they are going and forming the preganglionic parasympathetic nerves. Okay, parasympathetic nerves of thorax abdomen, which was the parasympathetic nerve there?
Vagus.
Vagus. Okay, now in the pelvic organs, for the pelvic region, you will please remember the parasympathetic supply that is coming through pelvic splanchnic nerves. Root value is S2, S3, S4. Okay. I'll show you what are preganglionic. Okay. So now from the sacral plexus, we also get the pudendal nerve, which goes and supplies the perineum. I told you so much now, a pudendal nerve block has to be given in order to perform any perineal procedures. Episiotomy.
Episiotomy, yeah.
Okay. So here we have discussed parasympathetic. So after parasympathetic, autonomous means it will have sympathetic and parasympathetic, no? So sympathetic is formed by pelvic part of sympathetic trunk. Can you see here? There is one sympathetic trunk which is going like this. Okay, sympathetic chain. Okay, which is seen right in front of the pelvic part of the sacrum. Okay, so sympathetic pelvic part of the sympathetic trunk it is. So these are the continuation of abdominal trunk. Actually, throughout the body, in the cervical region, you call it the cervical part of the sympathetic chain, thoracic part of the sympathetic chain in the thorax, isn't it? So these are all sympathetic nerves. Autonomous nervous system has two components, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Okay. So the sympathetic component is contributed by sympathetic chain, which is present throughout the vertebral column, on either side of the vertebral column. You can trace from the neck to the sacrum. The names are cervical sympathetic chain, thoracic sympathetic chain, lumbar sympathetic chain, sacral sympathetic chain, and finally both of them will join in the center to form ganglion impar. Okay. Mm-hmm. What are you finding on the screen?
Pelvic vessels and not internal area.
Okay. Okay. So this is the sympathetic chain, beta. Okay. So the sympathetic, see, pelvic part of the sympathetic trunk. These are the continuation of the abdominal trunks. They descend in front of the ala of the sacrum. Do you remember this point I told you as ala? Isn't it when we did osteology of sacrum? Ala of the sacrum. Okay. And they just come down and terminate inferiorly. Okay. In front of the coccyx. And together they are forming one ganglion in the midline. What is the name of this ganglion?
Ganglion
impar. Okay, ganglion impar. So now this sympathetic trunk is basically now is forming two plexuses, superior and inferior hypogastric plexuses. Okay, through which it will supply pelvic visceral organs, urinary bladder, uterus, and rectum anal canal. You see, this is our sympathetic chain. This is our sympathetic chain. This is the ganglion impar. This is sagittal section. Okay. And you are finding this is the superior hypogastric plexus, the one which is going up. Okay. Better pictures are also there. So, sacral plexus. See, the branches of the sacral plexus will be, anyhow, this is the topic of lower limb. It will have superior gluteal nerve. This all nerves which will be seen when you are doing the structures under the cover of gluteus maximus, in fact. Isn't it? Superior gluteal nerve supplies gluteus medius and minimus. Try to recollect superior gluteal vessels and inferior gluteal vessels and nerves you will see there. Okay. This is a part of actually lower limb. Okay. So because it is pelvic sympathetic chain, just because it is staking part, I have just put this slide. Okay. Just as a recapitulation, these are the branches coming from sacral plexus. Superior gluteal nerve, inferior gluteal nerve, nerve to piriformis, nerve to obturator internus, nerve to quadratus femoris, perforating cutaneous nerve and posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. All these you will see once you reflect the gluteus maximus. Under the cover of gluteus maximus, we will see. First, thick sciatic nerve will be seen. Isn't it? Piriformis is the key muscle. Above the piriformis, you will see superior gluteal vessels and nerves. Below that, you will see sciatic nerve is also coming and inferior gluteal vessels and nerves and all these nerves. Okay? No, sciatic nerve. This is all actually like a lower limb topic, but sciatic nerve. It divides in popliteal fossa into tibial and common peroneal nerve. Isn't it? This is more important now. That is all learned thing from the lower limb. Okay, now we will see the autonomic nerves. So in this autonomic, what is this? I told you sympathetic chain. Okay, so which is continuing as abdominal part of the sympathetic chain. This is the ala of the sacrum. Okay, and then this is the pelvic surface of the sacrum bone. Okay, which is running like this, and you can see it is joining in the center to form ganglion impar. Okay, so this is autonomic nerves. Autonomic means we have sympathetic and also parasympathetic. Parasympathetic is which one? Which I said?
Splenic.
Ye wala.
Plank.
Kya tha? S2, S3. Pelvic splanchnic nerves. S2, S3, S4. Autonomic will have parasympathetic also and sympathetic. Whatever chain you are finding, that is sympathetic. Okay, contribution from S2, S3, S4 will be parasympathetic. Okay. Okay. So this is which chain? Sympathetic. Okay. From S2, S3, S4, whatever we have, that is parasympathetic. So sympathetic and parasympathetic together, you call it as autonomic nerves. And pelvic visceral organs will have autonomous nerves, no? Autonomic nervous system supply by because these are visceral organs, they should contract and relax, isn't it? That means dual type of functions it will have, no? Urinary bladder will be full of urine. Okay, that means there will be stretching. Again, urinary bladder should empty where it contracts and lets the urine out, isn't it? So that those type of functions are controlled by dual supply, autonomic nerves. One is sympathetic and other is parasympathetic. So the autonomic innervation of pelvic cavity is via four roots. Okay, that is sacral sympathetic trunk. Okay, then periarterial plexuses. We will see, that means they form plexuses around the branches of the internal iliac artery. They form hypogastric plexuses, that is superior and inferior. We will see the pelvic splanchnic nerves also. What are pelvic splanchnic nerves? Just now I told you.
S2 to S4.
Parasympathetic. Mm-hmm. S2, S3 and S4. Okay. So now see here. Now this network. So this is sympathetic chain and S2, S3, S4. This is parasympathetic. And now they are forming certain, like both of them will join together. And of course they do their function separately only, but they form plexuses. So you are finding the plexus, which is, what is this vertebra? L5. No? Mm-hmm. What is this? Sacrum. So this is lumbosacral joint. This is the intervertebral disc. So at this point, okay, for your better understanding and try to remember easily, you have a plexus here. You call it as the superior hypogastric plexus. Similarly, when you come down, you know the names of muscles now, isn't it? What is the name of this muscle?
Piriformis. Piriformis.
Okay, piriformis. And this is our levator animal. So as you go down, you are finding there is one more plexus down. That is inferior hypogastric plexus. Okay. So through these, if you remember always when we were discussing sympathetic, parasympathetic, we were all these names were coming, like inferior hypogastric plexus and superior hypogastric plexus. Now, see what is this? See, first of all, we have this prevertebral plexus. Prevertebral means what? From the word, what do you mean? In front of the vertebral column, whatever nervous plexus is formed, you call it as prevertebral plexus. Okay, enters the pelvis as two hypogastric nerves. Okay, what are those? One on each side that cross the pelvic inlet medially to the internal iliac vessels. The hypogastric nerves are formed by the separation of fibers in the superior hypogastric plexus into right and left bundles. See, this is the superior hypogastric plexus, isn't it? So this is dividing into right and left bundles, right? So this is the part of the thing which is being dealt here. The hypogastric nerves are formed by the separation of fibers in the superior hypogastric plexus into right and left bundles. Okay? Mm-hmm. Initially, prevertebral means in front of the vertebra you had these nerves. That is the first point. Okay, enters the pelvis like two hypogastric nerves. Okay, they cross the pelvic inlet. The hypogastric nerves are now further dividing into right and left bundles. The superior hypogastric plexus is situated where exactly? Already I told you. Mm-hmm. L5 and promontory of sacrum. That is, it is situated anterior to the vertebra L5 between the promontory of the sacrum. And if the other landmarks, if you want to check, is bifurcation of aorta. Okay, bifurcation of aorta. That means this is L5 vertebra and this is the sacrum. This is the sacral promontory. Isn't it sacral promontory? At this point, you will also see the termination of the abdominal aorta into right and left common iliacs. So here you are finding the formation of the superior hypogastric plexus. There it is situated. Okay. I hope these points are clear.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So now again, this is the location, but this is higher up, whatever you are finding is this point, we will have superior hypogastric plexus. Lower down, we will have this one is inferior hypogastric plexus. So from this picture, you can see clearly where is it supplying? What is this? Urethra,